Okay, finally this 54th Massachusetts regiment is routed. They did a yeoman's job on the side there, really, you know, reinforcing my left, and they did their job. So now it's time for the 20th Maine to come in and see what they can do. This is Gettysburg all over again for them. They have to protect the left flank and prevent it from being rolled up. But you see some of Hood's Texans are coming in, and they're going to melee with my Iron Brigade. And my 20th Maine is getting there just in time to protect my flank. I mean, timing couldn't have been any closer. Much later than that, and the Confederates would have quickly rolled up my line there, and I would have lost that time I need to until I can get some help. But you can see right there, I have about five units of Confederates are still not yet engaged in advancing on my left. My Buford's cavalry is doing a great job on the side there, really extending my lines for me where it would have been tough for my infantry to, you know, I didn't have enough infantry to extend my lines, but they're holding their own there, firing off their horses and really doing a great job. Okay, you can see the Confederates are really just starting to overwhelm me on the left here. I don't really have enough units to protect my left flank here. But I'm doing the best I can to get some artillery fire on those other units. I'm rushing yet another unit over there, the Irish Brigade. I'm rushing them around the back there so they're not running in front of my artillery. And I will quickly get them in the mix as well. And you can see my first Iron Brigade unit routed. And here's my other Iron Brigade unit involved in melee. There's some of my artillery. And 20th Maine is just getting absolutely decimated. I mean, they're basically facing four units on their own over there, so they're really acting more as a sacrificial delaying force more than anything else right there. But quickly, I'm trying to get more units over there. There's the Irish Brigade, and they're getting over there quickly as well, so we'll see how that goes. Yet you could still see the Confederates are coming down the middle too, so I can't really ignore that. I can't bring too many of my units over, but I have to do the best I can to keep plugging that hole on the left to make sure that I don't get rolled up too early before my support can come. Oh, you can see that guy took a shot to the chest, and he's going to go down slow. That's from distance right there. It's either a lucky shot or something. Okay, you see my Iron Brigade right here holding up against these Hood Texans. They're severely depleted, well below a third strength, but holding their own. And finally, the 20th Maine gets overwhelmed. I mean, they're facing single-handedly four Confederate units right there. So you can see right there that the Iron Brigade is anchoring my left there. I'm quickly rushing over another unit to help plug the hole, but it's only a matter of time before the Confederates roll me up and start to, you know, push my flank back towards the center. Okay. You can see I lined up a unit there on my left. That's the Irish Brigade, and they're pretty fresh. They're going to come in there and get some shots off. And I spoke too soon. They took about 22 casualties with one artillery strike, and now they're facing an onslaught of, it's like Louisiana Tigers there rushing them.
Forward!
And there's my support, you can see, coming up very, very slowly. And I'm doing everything I can to buy all the time I can to get my support, you know, time to get up there. But right now you can see that once that Iron Brigade collapses on my left there, the Confederates, they're just going to roll me up. I don't really have a choice. Finally, my artillery is routing, vacating that area. And I'm going to start to turn my artillery around at this point, and I'm switching to canister shot, and I'm just firing into that big mass of Confederates to see what I can do to kind of slow them down a bit. You see the Iron Brigade. They're down to 12 guys, and they finally started routed. What a brigade right there. Man, look at all the chevrons they got. They got like 5-plus chevrons. I mean, for anchor in that corner. That Iron Brigade unit did some damage over there. I mean, they didn't even rout till they only had 12 guys left. That's pretty amazing. You know, those guys are, they're going to get the MVP of that, of this battle. All right, you can see my Pennsylvania ducktails in there. This guy took a bayonet right to the chest. Gonna slow things down a little bit, see what happens. Oh, that guy took a bayonet in the stomach. Let's see if his Union buddies can retaliate. Oh, and then right through the back. You see what that did? It even moved him while he was on the ground. Let's see what his friends do to retaliate. Some really good melee action here in Empire. Oh, you see his Confederate. Oh, he got the bayonet right in the gut. And then he's going to get that right in the back. Oh, man, that's got to hurt. I can't even imagine like that happening to me or even doing that to somebody. That's pretty crazy. But anyway, really nice melee fight here. You see all the strewn bodies in the background. This is just an amazing battlefield. We have close to 14 to 15,000 troops battling on this field right now. It's about all my computer can handle. But you just see the chaos right now. This battle is just getting out of control. It's like a melee fest right now. But, you know, I'm doing everything I can to buy time for my reinforcements to come. And it's taken all my skill and everything I know to do that. So let's see if I can hold up until, help arrives. And you can see help in the background right there. They're not far away. And right there you can see I have about 3 units going up against about 10 Confederate units. And, I mean, my guys can only hold up for so long. See the skirmish on the left there. My Irish Brigade fighting the Louisiana Tigers. I mean, those are some lame uniforms. I know that, you know, they wanted to have distinct uniforms to stand out, but how can you fight in that uniform right there? How do you feel tough in that thing? I don't really get it. Oh, look at the Union guy stomping on that guy's head and sticking him in the stomach with a bayonet. Unbelievable. These Irish guys are brutal. Alright, we're going back to regular speed here. Alright, so you can see some of my artillery is kind of hightailing it out of there. Whatever artillery I still have left that's set up is firing some canister into that big blob of Confederates right there. You can see my regular infantry is trying to get off as many shots as they can, but they're about to get slammed from the left by about 3 Confederate units. And finally, getting some reinforcements in here. Now, you know, fortunately, I was able to do, you know, serious damage to the Confederate army as a whole with only half, you know, the available forces. So, I think I did my job here, really inflicting as much damage as possible and really putting the Confederate army in disarray. Oh, you can see some of that canister hitting these charging Confederates there. That's going to make the Stonewall Brigade route right there. You can see they're going to go ahead and charge me anyhow in true Stonewall fashion. But really, I mean, I did a great job, I think, on the right here, holding off this whole army and giving, you know, the other half of the army a chance to get over here and help out. You can see my 24-pounder howitzer guys getting in there and involved in the melee fight. So you can see right here the my reinforcements marked with the blue edge around the flag are starting to really get involved in the fray, and they're starting to overwhelm the Confederates on this side. And they're relatively untouched, and, you know, haven't really been involved in the battle too much, but they're finally coming up and helping me out. You can see my final brigade right there, about 61 soldiers, is getting fired on from the side, and they're actually going to survive to the end of the battle, as are my artillery men in the background there. So I think at the end of the battle, my army has about maybe 60, 70 guys left. But they did a great job fighting, and, you know, we'll see how this battle turns out. All right, you can see a bunch of my units routing back there. You can see the overwhelming mass of Union forces coming in here to clean up the mess that I started. There's my Irish Brigade unit, still with 59 guys left. And those 24-pounder howitzer unit that we're routing, they're going to come back and finish the battle out as well. So you see all these Confederate units there are chasing my routing units. But pretty soon they're going to get back into the fight. But they're going to run into a wall of Union soldiers, this big mass over here. And it's not going to bode too well for them. You see those three guys in the middle. And as we fast forward to the end here, you see the final Confederate unit holding out. And the battle is over. So you can see the damage I did to the enemy. I mean, 4,600 enemies killed. So even though I lost, you know, half the army or my half that I was controlling, I mean, I really, did a great job. You see the Pennsylvania Ducktales there, Bucktails, got 637 kills. My 24-pounder howitzer, over 400. Buford's Cavalry that was anchoring my left there got over 328 kills. Irish Brigade, 341. And the Iron Brigade on that edge, 403 kills, anchoring my left there. But you can see the results there. Hope you enjoyed the battle.